Lynn to Covent Garden to the Met in New York. She's thrilled audiences and critics alike. But the power of the music she grew up with in church in Washington, D.C. is never far from her heart. For Denyce Graves, the spiritual is central to her experience, both as an artist and as an African-American.
They had, in fact, many different functions. Sometimes they were a way to communicate, as they weren't allowed to socialize. Sometimes, you know, for example, I think Steal Away to Jesus was a call that there would be a meeting place at a certain time in a certain place. And so they had many, many functions. But that they were born out of just such heartache and broken spirit. And I think that the reason that they're so powerful is just because that is all built into the melody somehow. And I don't know anybody who can't be moved by them. And there's so many ways to sing the same melody. You know, there's so many ways that it can mean something so different. It's true with everything. But I'm so proud that they're in its proper place. I know there was a time that African-American artists in particular didn't want to program them on recitals, or they weren't allowed to program them on recitals. And in fact, it was Harry Burley who was the first singer to begin this tradition of programming the spirituals on recital and concert. And I'm so proud of it because it's part of our heritage. It's who I am. There are melodies that I grew up hearing all my life, and so they're so familiar for me. It's like putting on a comfortable pair of shoes or something like that. It's a part of who I am.
Next Monday, the nation stops and observes the birthday of Dr. King. But, mm-hmm. of course, today, the 15th, is the day that Dr. King was born in mm-hmm. Atlanta. And I'm wondering, the spirituals were such an important part of the movement that Dr. King led. I wonder if performing spirituals, particularly at this time of year, has a particular resonance for you.
I think so. But for me, always, it doesn't matter when I hear them. And a lot of times, I carry the CDs around with me on the road, and I play them for inspiration. And I think, you know, Denyce, if those people could make it, they had something to sing about. You know, your problems are so small in comparison. So I'm greatly encouraged and inspired by them still. And whenever I hear them, they're magnificent compositions.
Well, here is some inspiration for us all. Mezzo-soprano Denyce Graves in a performance of 6 spirituals recorded in concert this past Friday night at the John F. Kennedy Center in Washington. We'll hear Witness, Give Me Jesus, Sweet Little Jesus Boy, in which she's accompanied by the Duke Ellington Show Choir, A City Called Heaven, Swing Low, Sweet Chariot, and Every Time I Feel the Spirit. The pianist is Warren Jones.
Samson with one. wandering about. Samson's strength was never found out. Till his wife sat upon his knee. She said, tell me where your strength lies, if you please. Well, Samson's wife, she talked so fair. Samson said, cut over my hair. Shave my head just as clean as your hand. And my strength will come like a natural man. Oh, Samson was a witness for my Lord. Samson was a witness for my Lord. Samson was a witness for my Lord. A soul is a witness for my Lord. There's another witness. Now there's another witness. There's another witness.
What a great voice. Mezzo-soprano Denyce Graves.